And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain.
There's a lot there for George and I. I don't know if I can talk about it with you, you know, but I don't really like to share some of the things, Ed. Probably not as ready as I would like to be. I don't think people knew him like I knew him. Today's player didn't really see him when I saw him when he was in full bloom. There's a lot of guys that couldn't really handle George. You know, he was great for me. We became great friends. That relationship that Bill Russell and Red Auerbach had, and the relationship that Bart Starr and Lombardi had, were, you know, something that I felt that George and I had, and I thought it was special, and I wanted it to stay that way, and I'm very proud of it.
It was an honor playing for him. It's an honor playing for his family still, because they have the same mindset, the same mentality. I think it's you know, every day you walk in the stadium, you think of the Boss, because we wouldn't be here if it wasn't for him. So you know, obviously he's passed away, but you thought about him even when he was still alive.
I think anybody that comes here and played for him knows that, you know, what he expected when you came here. You know, the bottom line was to win, and if you didn't win, you know, he was going to let you know about it. That's just his competitive spirit, and that's the way he wanted the Yankees to be, and it was just one of those things. And you know, as you go along, you know, you look back on the memories of being in this great organization and being a part of it.
Well, just, you know, the first thing I recall is all the managers that he fired. You know, I was here 11 years, and I think I probably played for 12 managers, so it's just a different manager every year. And just, you know, his impulsiveness is what I think about most of the years that I played here. He was a very impulsive guy, and he paid you well, and he wanted to make sure he got his money's worth.
He would come in there, and he would get on you, or he would drop a line in a paper about the way you would pitch. And what it would do is, when I would read it, or if he said it to me face to face, you know, the worst thing was it would get my dander up. So the next time I went out, I had that on my mind. But he used that. He was a good motivator. He used that to his advantage. And that's, he did. He actually made a lot of players a lot better, because he made you perform.
For me, it's obviously going to be the last time I was with him is what I'm going to remember the most. You know, I had a chance to go up to his suite in spring training and visit with him for a few innings up there. And I think we were losing the game 1-2 or 2-0 or something like that. It was in the 5th or 6th inning. And, you know, I was talking to him, telling him how I thought the team was going to be good. And the pitching staff was going to be solid. We're going to be good. And just like he was, I mean, it was almost like he was ignoring what I said. And he just said, well, we're not, we need to score some runs tonight. We're losing right now, you know. So that was George in a nutshell.
Well, he would be the first guy to kick you in the butt, and the first guy to put his arm around you. You know, when we lost in the playoffs, you know, I remember shedding a few tears in the players' lounge, you know, and very disappointed that we didn't win. And then he came in and he just put his arm around me and said, "Hey, man, we're going to get him next year," you know. And like I said before, if you weren't as demanding of yourself as Mr. Steinbrenner was of you, then it wasn't going to work out in New York.
The character that he has, and the willing heart to other people happy and help others, you know, that was, you know, and not many people knew about that he didn't want no media or nobody to know what his business was.